Hey guys, for absent students and if students at home are having some questions, I'm making this little video tutorial to show you how to do the bubble lab. Be sure to read the instructions and information carefully. Read it more than once if you have to. Under procedure, and I'm looking at mine I have up, population one, it says once the bubble leaves the wand, wave, blow, if at home we're not blowing in class, or fan in an effort to keep the bubble in the air and prevent it from breaking or dying. So you are the bubble parent, and population one, I think I'll change this to ABC, that might be easier, should represent, ideally our data should come out to represent a type one curve. There's lots of parental care, they have very few children, and it's the red one on your lab. So the way we're gonna get data, I have my bubble wand here, you're gonna blow some bubbles. Whoops. And then I'm gonna pick one and I'm gonna count 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and it died. Okay, so then I make a tally mark on my lab sheet, and I made a Google sheet for you. I had one bubble last 8 seconds. I wasn't trying to keep that one alive though, but let me try it again. This is my second one, and I'm doing 25 of these per population group. So I got lots of bubbles, so I'm gonna pick one. And this is a parental care, so I'm gonna try to keep this alive. And I wasn't counting, but you should count. It was probably alive for about 5 seconds. It's easier if you have a partner or if you're at home and a family member will help you. If you want to use a stopwatch, that's fine. If you're good at counting seconds accurately every time, you know, that can work too. So that would be my second one. All right, and then now let's track this one. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm not being a very good bubble parent. So ideally, if you like have a piece of paper and you can keep it alive, I'll do one more. So that would be number 3. I would put a tally mark by 8 seconds because that's how long that one lasted. Okay, this one, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, I killed it actually. That one lasted 8 seconds. Don't kill your bubbles, your bubble offspring, when you're trying to keep them alive. So then I'd have another tally mark at 8 seconds. And I would do that, I'd keep doing that until I have 25 marks on my Google sheet for the first population set. And then the second one, it says group members do nothing to interfere with the bubbles or keep them in the air. So that one is going to represent a type 3 curve where there's a lot of babies born, but most of them don't survive early on. And then population 3, it says create a line 1 meter from the bubble blower. If you're outside in the wind, it's a little windy, maybe you want it to be 2 meters. Try to blow the bubbles so they will cross the line. Bubbles that don't cross the line die at 1 second. So if they go off to the side, for example, bubbles that cross the line are timed until they pop/die. So again, you pick, it's easiest if you just pick and track one bubble at a time, even though you'll get lots every time. Group members cannot do anything to influence a bubble survival. So that one ideally would come out to be a type 2 curve, which is linear. and then looking at the questions, I care more about the fact that you learn about the survivorship curves more so, and that you have fun with the bubbles too, more so than if your data comes out to represent the type 1, type 2, type 3 curves. You are supposed to have read about these type 3 curves. So looking at the lab sheet, it shows a picture of the curves. And what I want you to do is in doing your lab report and answer the questions, just show that you understand about the survivorship curves. So question one says, examine the survivorship curves for the three soap bubble populations. How do they correlate with type 1, type 2, type 3 survivorship trends? Well, maybe one or two of them does and a third one doesn't, or maybe one of them does and the other two doesn't. Explain what you have, but then write something that shows that you understand what the three survivorship curves look like. Explain them, be able to give an example or two. Number two, do any of the bubble populations show constant death rate for at least part of their lifespan? Again, reference your actual data, but then the constant death rate is going to be type 2, so make sure you make note of that. Which type of survivorship curve describes a population of organisms that produces a very large number of offspring, most of which die at an early age? So look at the curves. Go back to the reading if necessary. Give an example. What reproductive strategy? So you guys learned about R selected versus K selected. So they'll be typically particular survivorship curve. Would you expect a population in which most members survive for a long time to produce few or many offspring? So there is a correct answer to that. And I think the other ones, with some research and reading, you should be fine on that. Notice that you're not creating your data. You're not creating an Excel or Google sheet from scratch. It's already there. So there's several documents for you to look out there. All right. And as always, let me know if you have questions.